Lovelies, my name is Jessica and welcome to Make a Misfit. And I'm so excited for this Panning Solitaire update. You guys, I did it. So if you don't know, I've been working on my Mercury retrograde palette. The packaging broke on me, so I decided to work on this palette in a Panning Solitaire style, which, if you're not aware, was the 2020, I believe, Fantastic Ladies Pan That Palette theme for that year. So Erynn Manning had created that theme, and she said that I could definitely name this project Panning Solitaire, as that is the style that I am working on this palette in. So the way I've been doing this is I'm rolling in a single. Once I hit pan on that single, I will then roll in a duo. Once I hit pan on both of those shades, I then roll in a trio. Once all three shades have a pan in it, then I go back to working on a single up until every pan in here is showing. So I'm very excited because I had finally hit pan on both of the shades in my duo. So I will show you a photo of what it was looking like at last update. And I am going to show you what it's looking like now. So as you can see, I have pan in Utopia finally. So my single was Frazzled. I did roll in Karma and Utopia as my duo. Last update, it was only Karma that had pan in it, and I finally was able to hit pan in Utopia right there. So it actually took me a total of 26 uses. Which I was surprised about because I had prior use on that shade before rolling it into this project, and Karma was hit first with no prior usage whatsoever. So in total, like, I don't keep track of my usage prior to or after a project, but I know for sure it was at least 30 plus uses to hit pan on Utopia, and Karma, I believe, took me like 16 or so. I'm not quite sure why. I know I was using different brushes and whatnot, so maybe that had something to do with it. Because of the state of my eyes and whatnot, I had to use a fluffier brush. But regardless, I'm so excited that I finally have pan in both of these shades that were in my duo, which means I get to roll in my trio today. So I'm so looking forward to that one. If you did not see my last update, though, I did mention that this shade right here, Momentum, is going to be part of my trio. And the reasoning for that is because the cream shade that I'm working on right now is pretty close to being finished. So I figured the next best option was to go and use Momentum as my cream shade since it is in this palette. So that means I will only be rolling in two shades to create my trio. So I do feel like by next update, Momentum should start to have some usage on it. We'll have to see how things go, but I'm very excited to roll in the next two shades to create this trio. So I'm not quite sure what we're gonna get, but we'll have to see. So there's going to be a total of 14 shades that I will be pulling from. So I have one, if I can get my finger on the shade. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. So I'm going to pull up pretty random on my phone here. We're going to see what I'm going to be able to get. So I'm going to put that down. Come on. So I have 1 through 14, and we are going to randomize two numbers. So number 3 and number 10. So 1, 2, 3 is Nebula, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 is Supermoon. Ooh, those are pretty. Okay, so Nebula is like one of my favorite shades in this palette. It's absolutely gorgeous, and so is Supermoon. They're both toppers, so I feel like this is going to be easy to hit pan in, especially Nebula. I think I'll be able to get some really good use on that. I don't know why I swatched them right there, but I did. You can't really see Supermoon because it is pretty light. It's got a clear base or a sheer base, whatever you want to call it. But I'm so excited that I rolled those two shades in. Oh, and I absolutely love Nebula. I do need to find my next glitter glue though, because I wore it to work one day and I had it all over my face, but like, people thought that I did that intentionally, so we'll have to see. Maybe it looks better than I think it does, but they are absolutely gorgeous shades. And then Momentum is the cream shade. So those are the three that I will be working on. I'm very excited, especially because I can usually pair Supermoon with absolutely anything. And Nebula would be good because I actually have some purples that I'm working on right now. So if I could top it off with Nebula, I think it's just going to be absolutely gorgeous. I'm so happy and so excited. I really do enjoy this palette. I actually purchased the rose quartz palette for my birthday during the Sephora sale. So I'm so excited to not only to continue getting used on this palette, but do eventually jump into that palette as well. And I purchased it mainly because of how much I thoroughly enjoy this palette. And just seeing Pan on here, it just makes me so happy and so excited, even though the packaging is a total disaster. So Momentum, like I said, that's the cream shade. That one I'm hoping will finally have some use on it next month by the update. That is going to be the only shade in that palette that will be completely finished. I would like to eventually finish every shade in the palette, but right now my goal for this project is just to hit the pan in every single shade. But because I do focus on one cream shade at a time, so I use it until it's completely finished, that one will be entirely gone out of this project. So after I hit pan in all three shades, I will randomize another single, but I will still continue to use Momentum until it's done. I'm not going to wait to roll in a single until I finish that shade. I just want to hit pan in it before I'm able to do so. So thank you guys so much for watching. I'm so excited about this one. I'm like, cannot wait to do my makeup tomorrow now. I would love to be able to roll those in. If you haven't seen any of my other updates, I think it was the last one, or not the last one, but the one before that. If I do hit pan on the shades before my update rolls around, I do actually randomize the new shades, but then I screenshot it and I show you guys what shades are being rolled in during the update. I don't always necessarily want to wait until the next update to roll in the new shades. I would like to just keep this going. I did hit pan in Utopia, I think it was like a week ago. So waiting a week isn't such a big deal, but I definitely don't want to wait like 2 weeks or even 3 weeks if it's such an easy shade. I would like to kind of keep it going as much as I can. So if I end up randomizing before the next update, like I said, I do screenshot it, show you guys, and we go from there. So thank you guys again so much for watching. I really do appreciate it, and I will see you all later. Bye.